It is one of the greatest unsolved mysteries of modern times. But be warned, it's also one of the scariest true stories ever told. This is the terrifying tale of the Dyatlov Pass incident. The year is 1959, the height of the Cold War and the dead of winter, when 9 Soviet university students embark on a hiking excursion into the frozen wilderness of Siberia and never return. A search party is dispatched and discovers their abandoned campsite on the slopes of a mysterious peak known as Dead Mountain. The bodies of the hikers are found scattered in the surrounding wilderness. The case inspires wild theories, ranging from top secret weapons testing, a murder cover-up, or even UFOs or attack by the Yeti. Investigators list the official cause of death as an unknown compelling force. But to this day, no one knows how the hikers died or why. Now, on the 60th anniversary of the hikers' deaths, an American survivalist thinks he's finally found the answer, while one of the world's leading experts on the event believes she can prove this was no accident. Together, they're mounting an expedition for answers, and I aim to join them. This will be the most remote journey in Expedition Unknown history. It will not be easy, and it will not be warm. But when it's over, we may finally solve the coldest case of all time.
Okay, here we go.
17,000 people live here on a ragged frontier. However, I'm here to meet another visitor like me, researcher Theodora Hadjiska.
Teddy.
Just so happy to see you.
Her friends call her Teddy, and Teddy is a hugger.
Yes. We're going to be doing a lot of hugging.
Okay, we'll be doing a lot of hugging. I'm okay with that. It's freezing.
She's also the world's foremost expert on the Dyatlov Pass incident, having compiled and translated every known document related to the case before putting it on the web for the public to analyze.
I've read everything I think that you've written about this case. You done amazing work. I think you know everything there is to know about this case.
Nobody knows everything about this case, Josh. I can assure you of that.
Teddy, when did you first get interested in this story?
I started reading and trying to figure out what exactly happened, and that was driving me nuts.
The story is, it's sad, it's tragic, it's macabre, but there's something really mysterious about it.
And the more you read, the weirder it gets.
Right.
Nobody could be prepared for how weird. When rescuers arrive on scene at the Dyatlov Pass weeks after the incident, the first thing they discover is the group's empty tent and cold weather gear. Their food and supplies are intact. Even stranger is the hiker's stove, which despite an estimated temperature of 35 degrees below zero on the night of their disappearance, was packed away unassembled. The day after locating the tent, the first two bodies are found near a cedar tree. They're shoeless, dressed only in their underwear. Over the next several days, more bodies are recovered in various states of undress, with bizarre injuries, massive chest fractures, some with their eyes and tongue missing. It takes months to find all the hikers. And in the end, investigators are left with no explanation as to what happened.